Hey everyone, Social Solipsist here, and I have a treat for you. Bethesda contacted me directly and said I could play the new Prey game that they announced. This is pre-release footage, and man, I am totally lying to you. I was watching the Bethesda press conference earlier at E3, and they announced the new Prey game, and I felt that it would be worthwhile to show you guys this game because it's a fairly unknown game. Prey was originally released back in 2006, so it's now 10 years old. To not a lot of acclaim, some pickiness and this, that, and the other thing, and it's an odd game. It was in development all the way as early as 1995. And jumped around a lot before eventually being released. And because it's sort of an oddity, it didn't get a lot of press. And there's, you can read up the Wikipedia page on it, and I'm sure you'll get a lot more information than I can give you. I did play this not back in 2006, but a little bit later. I think I originally played it in 2009 or 2010. And I never finished it. It's like I said, it's a bit of an oddity. It really combines a lot of aspects of a lot of different genres. It's a first-person game that combines sci-fi, Native American mysticism, puzzles and platforming, and a whole lot of other weird stuff. As much as I never finished it, and mostly because of just how weird it is, it is worth taking a look at, especially considering the fact that the new game will be coming out in the foreseeable future. I think they put the date on of within the next year or something like that, but I could be misremembering. They made a lot of announcements. But like I said, I think it's worthwhile to take a look at, and so we're gonna do exactly that. I should say, actually, part of the reason I'm excited for the new sequel is not only just because of the footage, or well, I should say footage, but it was a cinematic trailer they showed. The new game looks pretty good, but also because this game here was originally supposed to have a sequel, it's called Prey 2, and it was not owned by Bethesda at the time. It was another production by 3D Realms and 2K, I believe, and some concept art came out for it, and it looked very sort of cyberpunk future type of thing, and it looked really interesting. I actually reported on it way back in the early days of my YouTube channel. I'll put the video in the description if you have any interest in looking at it. But anyway, without further ado, let's take a look at this because it really is worth looking at. Just to be clear, I have hacked the hell out of this game just to get it to run on my Windows 7, not that new system. Does not have 1920 by 1080 as a native resolution. It does have 1920 by 1200 though, for some reason. Like I said, it's a little weird. We're gonna play at the average difficulty level because it is not an easy game. Like I said, this was in a development for a
World
long
is
time,
full
and
of
it kind of
stories,
shows.
and from time to time, they permit themselves to be told.
What are you looking at? Real tough guy. Can't even tell her you love her. I gotta get off this damn reservation. If she'd just come with me, it'd all be different. It'd all be. Listen to yourself. Who do you think you're kidding?
Tommy, get your ass out.
We've got some serious screen tearing. I'm gonna see if I can fix that. So this is your character. You are a Native American person.
Doesn't anyone ever
I
clean this
believe he's
place?
Cherokee, if I remember correctly. And some people like to chalk up the lack of success of this game to, oh, you couldn't relate to the character, which I find to be bullshit, but people like to pull that stuff. Blame anything for the lack of success. Let's see if I can fix this now. It is not running at 640 by 480. I am hoping I can fix this without totally breaking the game. Yes. Oh, I'm gonna break it, aren't I? Please don't break it. It didn't break it. It appears to still be recording. I am praying that it didn't break the recording. It looks fine in OBS. So we're gonna keep going. That seems to have mostly fixed the screen tearing. So I'm pretty happy with that. FYI, if you are looking to play this, I would...
Tommy, Anisi, what are you doing here?
I sense great change on the winds. I came to warn...
Save it, Grandfather. You know I don't go for that shit.
Listen, Tommy. You cannot turn your back on your heritage any longer. It will give you strength.
Strength? For what?
To save yourself. To survive.
Survive? What are you talking about, Anise? Go home.
My place is here, by your side. You will have need of me this night.
Sure, whatever.
I also need to get the subtitles on. Let's fix that real quick. Let's see, where is that? It's probably under game options, right? Let's see. Allow profanity, yes. Subtitles, yes. Wait, what was that? Feel? Adaptive difficulty. I'd forgotten about that. I've forgotten about a lot of this. Like I said, it's been a while since I've played. So what I was gonna say was that this...
Looks like Jen's running low on Ryan Red.
Getting this game right now, if you don't already own this game... Back patio closed for repairs as of May. If you don't already own this game, you're not going to own it now. Unless you want to buy a used copy, it's not going to happen. Because as far as I'm aware, there is no digital option available. Because the IP has traded hands a couple of times, you know, even the fact that Bethesda picked it up to do some work on it, like, I don't know who even owns this version.
My wife loves that turquoise crap.
This is a bar. We don't sell jewelry.
It is interesting to see they've actually got actual...
Drink up, boys.
Man, they need some new tunes in this thing.
I think all of these are actual albums and things, and I think you can actually play them all. We are going to turn it down, because I don't want to get a copyright strike, but...
Hey, Tommy!
I don't want to talk to you yet. There's a lot of weird stuff in this game. It's quite unusual.
Get lost, asshole.
All right, redneck. We're just gonna play around a little bit. Like, by all accounts, this was more detail than they needed to put in. Anyway, I could waste away at that. I know, but not yet. I gotta look around. So, by all accounts, for a 10-year-old game, this looks pretty great. I mean,
what's up, babe?
Things are a little stretched out and, well, we gotta talk now.
Nice, clean box.
Sorry, babe.
Hey, clean's with Ray. How about a couple more beers over here?
Aw, look at these racist fucks. I've got a wrench!
kill you.
Making a mess. Throwing cigarettes on the floor. You bastard. Yeah, not a whole lot to do in here. This is not where, we don't stay in here that long.
She has a hell of a way of showing it.
She is Cherokee. She is bound to this land. Asking her to leave is asking her to give up a part of her soul.
But doesn't she want something better than this?
To be among one's own people. To truly know where you belong. If there is something better in this life, I have not seen it.
That's because you never left.
So Tommy's not super respectful of his culture.
The Aniwaya sense the coming of the storm.
Annie, what?
Wolves. Something spooked them. Earth to Tommy.
The fact that they even bothered to model what little is outside is kind of surprising. I mean, like I said, 10-year-old game. Doesn't look that bad.
So, did you think about what I said?
Tommy, not this again.
Come away with me.
Her ears are kind of fucked, though.
Off the reservation.
Why can't we just be together here?
You know why. I hate this place. It's a goddamn cage. It's no way to live.
This place is my home. My job is here. My family is here. Do you think you're saving me by taking me away? I'm Cherokee, Tommy, just like you. You should be proud of that.
Look, I know the tribe's important to you. It's just, it's never meant anything to me.
Hey, Pocahontas, let's have two more cold ones over here.
Last call, boys.
Already?
It is 2 a.m.
Hell no, that ain't right.
It's time for you boys to leave.
After you've been wagging that pretty little ass at us? I don't think so.
And Tommy. Off.
I will hit you.
One little kiss. Where's the harm in that?
Fuck off!
Ooh, where's that famous engine hospitality, huh?
Don't touch her.
All right, then.
Where's my wrench? Get it!
It's on now.
Get it! Get him!
Now you really pissed me off.
Get him! Get him! Get him! Good old boy. Dead.
Yeah, I should.
That's not what I meant.
Look at all this gore on my wrench.
What the hell?
Oh shit. Civil emergency. What's up? That wrench looks fucking grisly. They didn't pick it for no reason. Yeah, like I said, this game gets weird. Well, there they go, and here I go. So that's the start of this game. It's a weird one. We're gonna have some fun. Well, there's her girlfriend.
Oh my god.
There's other beings. Yeah, I bet you weren't expecting this, were you? Maybe you were. Maybe you know something about this game. But, now we get to see ourselves.
Grandfather. Neither can I.
Where the hell are we? What's going on? What are they gonna do to us?
I don't know, Jen. Stay calm. I'll get us out of here. Just give me a minute.
Help, somebody, help.
What the fuck are those things?
Well, the elites have come to take us away. What's the actual name for the elites? It's the Sangheili or something like that, I think. Am I remembering that right? I don't know. It's an interesting question to think whether this, whether those designs, whether any of these designs were made before or after Halo. Like I said, development originally started in 1995, so could be debated forever which way it went. And I do, by the way, I do have control over the mouse or over the camera if it wasn't immediately apparent. Well, that dude's setting a bomb. But he seems to be on our side.
Gives life to all worlds. Help us in our time of need. Deliver us from evil. Uniqua, whose breath gives life to all worlds. Help us in our time of need. Deliver us from evil. Uniqua, whose breath gives life to all worlds. Help us in our
Serves you right, redneck. From evil.
Uniqua, whose breath gives life to all worlds. Help us in our time of need. Deliver us from evil.
Jen, stop. I'm trying to think.
Uniqua will hear me.
If there's a great spirit, he's not here.
This might not go well. But it'll probably go okay.
Shit. Oh no.
We're gonna fall. And here we are. But there goes her girlfriend, so we gotta find our way to her. Huh.
Open the anus.
Alright, we're on our way. Now, some of the UI elements are probably gonna look pretty messed up because it was not intended to run at this resolution.
Hey man, are you okay?
Shit, guess not.
Better off this way.
Sorry, bro. Let's see. What do we got? Alright. We can go one way or the other. I guess we can't go that way. Never mind. I think I made it probably 5 hours into this game. And it was just too weird and at times way too hard for me to play. But I was also playing it on a much older system that could not play it nearly as well. Or make it look nearly as look nearly as pretty. So
fuck you, you worm thing.
Oh, that's weird. Huh. I wonder it's kind of weird, isn't it? It's almost like we're warping time and space. I am messing with you guys a little bit. A lot of this game is about... when it's not about shooting, it's about
what the hell is this place?
The twisting of time and space. I almost just said it's like a companion piece to Portal. I don't think that's very fair. But in the whole sort of Portal warping of time and space stuff, it's almost a precursor. When did Portal come out? What was that, 2008? 2009? Is it later than that?
This is impossible.
Well, those are guys running on the walls. Wonder what that could mean.
I feel good.
So those are health packs. There's our low-res loved ones being held and tortured. Alright. So, if we go through this way, go one way. If we go through this way, it's another. So, it's slowly but surely teaching you some of the mechanics. Oh, I saw your eyes, bro.
What the hell are they doing to these people?
Jesus. That is something, huh? What the fuck? Why are there tentacles growing out of the walls?
Jen!
I haven't watched enough anime to know how that goes.
Hold on.
Jesus, there's a lot of shit here. That's just moving on its own. I didn't even do that. Well, we can't stop it, and we can't go. So, there goes Grandpa.
Don't worry, he'll be back!
But I guess we can't leave yet. But that's all that's left of Grandpa. But this guy wants to help us out. So we're making some quick work of these levels. Admittedly, it is still very much the intro. Well, I could touch that thing, but I trust whatever this is more.
Oh God, what did I just do?
May have been ill-advised. Now what could that possibly be? Whatever it is, it looks sinister. Looks like they're gonna capture the Earth and extract all the words out of it.
Same kind of energy as those spores.
Well, something vomited on me and I felt better. Good to know. Oh, oh, hello. Please, please, please don't hit me. Oh, look, a gun. Now, there's some really interesting designs in this game. This first gun that you get is pretty great because all you gotta do is sort of stare at it and appreciate, like, it's got little tubes of energy and then glowing rods and like a teeth claw thing. It appears to be alive by all accounts. And it's even got a scope with some alien runes. Anyway, it's a pretty great gun. Pretty great little design. Very unique, very appropriate for the setting. What could that be? Little robots. I could do that, or I could go in here.
That felt weird.
Now there's more health and stuff over there. Probably get over there in a few minutes. It's always a little hard to tell where you're gonna end up. But it appears we just warped right over. Now, I can try and go through this door, but it's locked. So we're gonna jump down into this area.
Southwest, I'm Art Bell, and we're gonna start the night by opening up the lines and
They're tapping into our radio frequencies, which is quite interesting. And that looks like something I don't want to touch, but we're going to touch anyway. Do I have to shoot it? Maybe I don't have to do either of those things. Like I said, it's been a little while since I've played this. Oh, well, look at this. I wonder if that could have something to do with it. It does. So, teach you a little something something. Well, now I'm tripping out again. Seems normal around here. That's got a red reticle on it. But I also don't really want to fight it. So when you drop into the scoped mode, you do get a lower rate of fire. But it does appear to do more damage. Bro. You're wearing the same underwear as that other guy. And you've got seams in your shoulders! But for all my complaints, game's 10 years old. It'd be hard for it to look a whole lot better than this. And this is an unmodified version. No texture swaps, no nothing. Let me through! I'm an alien! I've got four fingers. Now, guess we have to go over here. Now, what the heck is that? Guess it's not something we can. Oh! Hello, crab guy! It bit me. So I'm gonna use it as a grenade. Yep. Deal with it. We use crab grenades here. Now this looks like a slide. Now why would they want me to use a water slide? I wonder. Oh! Because we're gonna warp time and space again. Welcome to this world. So a lot of the levels are this kind of stuff. And I have to say, the controls are not as tight as you want them to be on the movement, so it's a little floaty and not incredibly pleasant to navigate all of this stuff. But generally speaking, I don't recall that being my issue with the game as far as difficulty goes. The difficulty always came in firefights and things like that. Generally speaking, the puzzles are fairly simple. Don't require a whole lot of really, you know, crazy thought or anything like that. However, you do have to put into perspective that because there are people on potentially all surfaces, you got to keep your eyes out in ways you wouldn't in your average shooter. And I do have a bit of vertigo personally, and this game definitely gets on it a little bit. So I may have to do this in shorter chunks than usual. And some of you may also find it equally kind of, I don't want to say unpleasant, but a little weird. So feel free to pause the video and give yourself a minute to recover. It doesn't help that I've also been not feeling super great recently. Guess I have full ammo. Now, what could this be? That looks like a rock. Why is there a rock? Guess I can't get it that way. Wonder if that could be it. I'm an alien! Well, that looks like a one-way tunnel. Guess we're just gonna have to take it. Unless we can go out. But we can't. Oh, Lord. Okay. Crouch and then fall flat on your face. Oh. Wait a minute. Oh my God.
He's a giant.
I'm not here. I'm not here. I'm not. Nope. Nope.
Oh, shit.
Nope. I was never here. I was not on this small rock inside this case. I don't know what you're talking about. With my mini gun. Get it? Mini gun. Oh no, now he's here with me! But it's okay. So now we are not only warping time and space, but also apparently gravity and a few other things. Clearly this has self-sustaining gravity of its own, based on the way that we are sticking to its surface at all times. I'm not sure how many of those guys I have to kill before I can go back through the portal before it reactivates. Might only be two, but I don't think so. Where are you? Where are you, little alien man? I need to kill you. Slightly disorienting. Well, if I can't find him in a moment, I'm gonna have to try something else. Oh. Never mind. There was another thing. Oh, good. Another portal. He's not wrong.
This is fucked up.
Oh, I guess they were already dead. Oh well. Ammo wasted. Through another portal. Please don't shit on me, or vomit, or whatever this is. Oh. Oh. Oh no. I don't want that. No, please. Please don't. That is disgusting. That is just gross. Does nobody maintain this place?
Hey, stop that thing. Mommy, help me, please. Jen, I'll find a way to get you off that.
Well, it's still alive. That's terrifying. Those are just arms. I guess that's how they jib.
These bastards will pay, Grandpa. I promise.
Now, why do they still have images of him rolling when he is dead? That was... Oh, shit. Clever girl. Man, why am I always tripping balls? Wonder if that has anything to do with this game. We are going to find out. And I definitely don't know anything about what's going to happen. Definitely not, despite what I've said. What up, buddy? You're wearing the same underwear as everybody else. Why does everybody wear red underwear? Kinda weird. You're not Mormons, but you all wear the same underwear like it's magic. Ruh-roh. Well, would you look at that?
Where in the hell am I?
Well, buddy. Looks like you're off the reservation. Anyway, moving on. Tommy got his wish. He is no longer anywhere on Earth. Although, if he couldn't have figured that out by now, well, probably something larger wrong with him. Hello, friend. Another friend. Yeah, trying to aim at all angles also is something you have to get a little used to. I'm not going to claim to be at any level of proficient at it, but it does take a little bit of doing.
Oh god, I'm being vomited on.
I have, I'm not wearing my headphones. Oh, hello.
Bastards.
If I get close to you, are you going to attack me? Nope. Oh, yes. Yes, you are. That's fine, though. So I've got a wrench. You don't have a wrench. Hello, friend. Oh, yeah. Just drop whatever you're doing to pick a fight. I guess you're very bored at work, huh? Just wanted some health. But you had to go and be a dick. Alright. So, these appear to grow in little pods. Let's see. I probably need one of these somewhere around here. Wander.
Die!
You dick. Look at that hand just falling off. Not entirely unique designs here, but for the enemies, that is. But definitely unique enough that makes them interesting. Now, I think we need to push this over here. Yep. Oh, hello. Hello, friend. You have any other friends around here? I bet you do, you sneaky son of a bitch.
This looks safe.
Sure does, Tommy. Sure does. Yeah, something tells me OSHA hasn't inspected this place in a long time. For those of you non-Americans, OSHA is the government department that, oh boy, generally makes sure that your workplace won't kill you. They want me to die! I can't have that happen!
It is time to let go of the mortal world, Tommy.
God damn it, Grandfather.
Of the sacred fire. Let go.
Here's where it gets weird. Just kidding, it's been weird for a while.
Come, Tommy. Join me.
Grandfather? What is this? Where am I?
Why are you a bird, Grandfather?
Bird Father!
It can't be.
This is some trippy shit. Nope. This is definitely weird. Oh, look, it's Grandpa.
I saw you die. Where? Where am I?
This is the land of your fathers, Tommy. The land of the ancients.
I'm a force spirit.
All that Cherokee crap, it's a bunch of superstitious bullshit.
You're standing in it, dumbass.
I don't believe this.
Your beliefs will soon change.
How did I get here?
Your spirit guide, Talon, brought you here.
Well.
Talon, my pet hawk? He's been dead since I was a boy.
All your life you have rejected the ways of your ancestors. Now you must embrace your heritage if you are to survive.
I don't have time for this. Jen's in trouble. I've got to find her.
You must learn the old medicine, Tommy. It is the only way. Let me show you.
Grandpa, you've shown me a lot of shit already. I'm a little scared. Now, credit where credit's due. For a 2006 game, this looks pretty damn good. There's a lot of places they could have cut corners here. The skybox especially. And definitely gotten away with it without too much critique. And they chose not to. So, props to them for that. On the other hand, admittedly, 2006 was 10 years ago, and I could be romanticizing the graphics of the era. But, to me, you know, if you popped this out as an indie game right now, it would probably still get some pretty good reviews. Like, despite the quality of the graphics. This is still passable today, by all means. Not great. Not great. But definitely passable. Fucking hell, grandfather.
What the hell is this? Let me out of here. I've got to get back to Jen.
No, let me out.
Always, if you are to succeed, you must step outside your earthbound shell, Demacia. Let your spirit carry you where your body cannot pass, through the fire.
Oh, of course. I'm just in a spirit walk. That makes sense. Now there's all these runes and shit. So, gotta press this as a spirit.
You may now return to your body.
Return to the body.
You have learned well. No mortal obstacle can stand in the path of your spirit.
Damn it, bird.
Send me back.
First, you must master the bow. You must learn to fight.
Not a problem. The army taught me to kill, remember?
You fought in white man's wars, with white man's weapons. Now it is time to fight with your own. Go to the spirit cave.
Oh, good. Aw, yeah. Bow and arrow. Let's get this shit.
This bow is the weapon of your spirit form, but your bow must be replenished. Claim the spirits of your fallen enemies. There is still much to learn.
Tommy the Soul Sucker.
Grows ever stronger.
I don't have time for this. Jen needs me.
As you wish. Talon will guide you. He will become your eyes and ears. Heed his warnings well.
All right. Well, that's the end of Mystic stuff, at least for now. Now, I'm not going to claim to be any great mind when it comes to Cherokee culture, or even know what I'm talking about. But something tells me that this is not entirely accurate to Cherokee belief system.
Who said that?
So I will let better people than me answer whatever questions you may have about that. In fact, I believe there's a section on the Wikipedia page regarding it. I was not paying attention at all to what she said. It's still alive! Come with me. Yep, a lot of stuff they could have cut corners on, and they just didn't. Props to them. Doesn't make a fantastic game, but it makes an okay game a bit better. That's just a light. Aww. Can't shoot him.
Let your spirit carry you where your body cannot pass.
Ah, look at that. Where am I going now? Opening the door? Is that what I have to do? Oh, I fucked up. Walked away too early. Guess that's not it. What do I need to do here? Something up here? Something... What do I do, Talon? What do I do? I thought I knew what to do, but I don't. Look at that derpy son of a bitch. What do I do? Talon, help me. I honestly don't know what to do. It's kind of embarrassing. Thought I would just go through here. But apparently, that's not it. Talon! Talon! What do I do? What do I do? Oh. That looks like... Nope. Guess not. Well. Hmm. Oh. I should probably use that thing. You're probably all yelling at me. Anyway, moving right along. Seriously, no one ever cleans this place. Shit, dude. Oh. Shit, man, you scared me. Alright, let's get a little health there, reactivate this, nope, that's not what I wanted. Activate the walkway, and I think we're probably going to need this. Possibly not though, might just be crazy. Oh no, hello. Now, trying to orient yourself to all this is messing your brain up. Don't worry. You're not alone.
This is definitely weird, but it could come in handy.
Organic threat detected. Heavy weapons authorized. Shit. I keep pressing the wrong thing. It is a little bit of an oddity that there's a contextual use for, instead of the fire, to clicking to fire, you click to interact. Definitely a little odd. Very much a rarity. At least in more modern games. Oh, hello. You've been shooting my body while I was not in it. Please don't do that. I need it to live. Well, looks like we can't go in there. Let's go in this way. Heal up again. What could this be?
All right. This'll rock some shit.
It sure will. Machine gun. Look at that. Saw that guy come in, but I don't really want to fight him yet. Not as accurate as you would like it to be, but it's alright. Oh, I knew there was another guy. Fuck off. Not my real dad. Leech. I wonder. Hey, look at that. Full ammo again. Oh. Kill those things. Fill right back up. Or can I not get up there anymore? I can, but it's empty. Oh well. That's alright. You will notice that there isn't an actual proper ammo counter, which is a little bit odd. But, fuck you! Anyway, we just hit a save point, so I'm actually going to stop the video here. Thank you guys for watching. I'm hoping you'll stick around and watch the rest of this playthrough. My intention is to do a full play, more or less. It's not an incredibly long game, as far as I'm aware. And I think it'd be good to get something long-term on the channel. So, if you enjoyed the video, please watch more. Please come back. Please subscribe. And let me know what you think in the comments. And I'll see you guys next time. Thanks, guys.